find the shaded area shown in the diagram. We're going to split the shaded area into two parts because part A, I'm going to shade here, is below the x-axis. So when we integrate that, we're going to get a negative answer. And part B, I've colored it green here, is above the x-axis. So when we differentiate this, we're going to get a positive answer. So we're going to have to do this in two parts. The general rule to find the area between a curve and the x-axis is given by the area is the integral between the limits b and a of the function with respect to x, because we're finding the area with the x-axis. So let's get area A first. Area A is negative, so it's going to be negative. The limits here are 2 and 1 because that's where it's crossing the x-axis of the function x squared minus 4 dx. So we integrate this quadratic by increasing the power by 1, dividing by the new power. So we get x cubed divided by 3 minus 4x plus c. The limits here are 2 and 1. So this means we're going to sub in 2 into the function first and subtract the answer when we sub in 1. So subbing in 2, 2 cubed is 8, so that's 8 over 3, minus 4 2s are 8, plus c. And we're taking away when we sub in 1. So 1 cubed will be 1, so that's 1 over 3, minus 4 times 1, which is 4, plus c. Now, we could have crossed this out earlier, or not included it at all if we wish in definite integrals, but the c values here cancel out. So just evaluating these fractions, it's negative 8 thirds take 1 third, and we have a negative 8 and plus 4. We can stick this in the calculator if you want, but this is 1 and 2 thirds. And the area B, the limits this time is between 2 and 4, so 4 and 2 are the limits. It's the same function we're integrating, so again we get x cubed over 3 minus 4x plus c. But this time we're subbing in the numbers 4 first and subtracting the answer when we sub in 2. Again, we'll see the c values are cancelled out. We're going to be adding and subtracting c values here. Evaluating this, you could use a calculator again, but we have 64 over 3, take 8 over 3. That's 56 over 3. And we have a negative 16 plus 8, which is negative 8. So this is 10 and 2 thirds. So the total area will be the sum of these two parts. So we have 1 and 2 thirds and 10 and 2 thirds, which is a total of 12 and 1 third. 37 over 3 if you wish. And units squared.